to find sampling distributions of our Gatoke planted tree. Now, we were first supposed to gather up in groups of five and get 5 trees each and calculate their circumference. Now, after the calculating the circumference, which was supposed to be at the height of the shortest limb of the group, we'll go to the next 5 and calculate their circumferences and find a mean. So we'll do that consecutively 5 times until we get 5 means. After getting those five mean circumferences, we were supposed to tally them up and go to other groups and get 5 other means, which makes a total of 6 groups. And 5 times 6 is 30. So in total, at the end of it all, we were supposed to have 30 values. Now after getting those 30 values, which are all means of the whole Gatoke plantation, we were supposed to form a frequency distribution table. Now, a frequency distribution table, you get your 30 values, put them into tables of the values themselves, and then you tally them up and find their frequencies. Then you find the frequencies times the values themselves. And then after that, they told us to find, using the distribution table, they told us to find the mean. Now, how you find the mean, it's the normal formula of statistics. It's the summation of fx over the summation of f. And now that mean that you get from that table is the mean mu. It's the mean of means in layman's language. It's the mean of the means. So you get your mean mu. Then after that, they told us to find the variance of these means. Now the variance, you get it from, again, a statistics formula. Summation of fx squared over summation of f minus the mean squared. Now that's your variance. So you substitute your values from the distribution table into that pre-programmed formula and you get your variance.
So you have calculated. Because when we have the x bar, we get the mean. Which is the mean of the population. We get their variance, which is equal to
standard deviation squared over the n-th number of values
in each sample. Where now n is what? 5. So from this working, this one we know. This one we know. We can also read this. So where we are heading is to use our information in the different samples to get the mean and the variance for the whole population of these banana bodies.
So what does variance supposed to symbolize?
It shows, because variance is the mean of square deviation. Standard deviation is the mean of deviation. So, how does each plant deviate away from the average?
Like we need
circumference.
Three of you, three more.
So the value you get as variance. How each, the value you get as variance, when you take the square root of it, you get the standard deviation. Now the standard deviation will tell you the standard way each plant varies. Circumference of each plant varies from the circumference.
After finding the variance, the significance of the variance is to show how each plant deviates from the average circumference. That each plant deviates by a standard value of 5 centimeters from the average circumference of the plants in the garden. That was our aim today, to find the variance.